This is the respirator that protects me from breathing small floating pieces of sharp glass, frit, and powder. If you heat up your rods in the oven till they're pretty hot, 1050, 1100 degrees, and then chop them into a bowl of water, you'll find that they fracture and crack in the water so that they're much easier to break up in your frit masher. You'll also find that the hotter you heat your rods and the colder the liquid that you put them into, the smaller the particles will become. Take a look and see how easily they break. They just finger break, they finger fall apart. This way, when you put them into your frit masher, they break up much more easily. This is the frit masher, a steel piston which fits exactly inside a steel cylinder. Place enough of the water fractured rods into the bottom of the frit mashing cup. I like to use a piece of cloth over the top of it while I'm mashing because that helps to minimize the amount of glass dust that shoots out of the frit cup while I'm mashing. Take a look to see the size of the frit that you've made. If it's too big, you may want to mash it up a little bit more. I'll pour the frit from the cup into a large mesh strainer over a steel bowl. This will help me do my first sift, which will take out the biggest particles. Next, I'll take a slightly smaller mesh strainer and sort the frit through that also. What falls out of the bottom of that is very nearly powder, and what remains is, we'll call it grade B frit if A is the largest and C is the smallest. And I sort them into three different bowls, and I will put them into three different containers because I'll use them for different purposes.